Well, hello, and welcome to Garrett Plays With Himself in The Suicide of Rachel Foster. Last time, we looked in on what the ghost hunters had experienced. We got a new little tool or utensil to figure things out. And it seems that Nicole is going a little bit batshit crazy with the 5 days, 6 days of isolation that she's been in this hotel for. She's dug out the old family Christmas tree, set that up, and... well, I imagine she's going to have to explain a few things to Irving. Or maybe she doesn't have to explain them, but she's probably going to tell him about it in casual conversation. He's going to be like, okay, that's not weird. No, that's totally not weird. I think that would actually be an effective way of abating cabin fever. Ooh, we're in day 7, actually. Holy shit, I forgot. Yeah, day 6 was when I got my little tool from the ghost hunters. And we're playing off-brand Christmas music, too. That's awesome. Okay. Yeah, I'll report in on the... oh, so we cleared out this so we can actually go through here now. Ooh, I'll use that in a moment because that's going to take me to a completely different place. Alright, let's report in on the Christmas tree. Wait, so... Montana trees. Merry Christmas.
Here I am.
You still there?
Where else should I be?
What day is it?
Did you forget what day it is?
I wouldn't miss Nicole's amazing adventures in the remote mountains for anything.
Irving, don't tell me you're staying on just for me. Go. I promise not to get into any trouble for the rest of the night.
Yeah, that's not our decision.
I'm sticking around till you get closure.
Thank you.
Thanks.
That's really sweet of you, Irving.
You always do that?
Nothing new on our board?
Worry about every desperate stranger that knocks on your door.
You're no stranger.
You trying to tell me something?
But I don't get it.
You've been a part of this place since you were born. You belong here.
Well, I thought I left all this behind. Maybe I still have a ways to go. To be free?
You're making progress. 2 days ago, you would have skinned me alive if I'd called you a country bumpkin.
I thought you were a Boy Scout back then.
2 days ago, I imagined you as a pimply kid from rescue services with a Boy Scout complex.
Pimply? My skin is as smooth as a 12-year-old's.
Ew.
It's good we're just talking on the phone, then.
Listen, is this... contraption really a phone? It feels like a walkie-talkie slash defibrillator.
It's a real phone, and trust me, in a few years, everybody'll have one.
Wait, are you calling me over voice over IP?
For me to believe in ghosts.
Yeah, the dial-up, I suppose it literally is VoIP.
When they're out and about.
I'm grateful for it. I wouldn't have met you without it.
Oh no, he's calling me on a cell phone. That's it. I'm glad you're here.
Well, I'm glad you're here. Yep, I probably would never have said that either 2 days ago.
The human interaction is definitely needed.
Over,
we could wait.
Me, you, us.
Do you always hit on people that you're a lifeline to, FEMA boy?
Same. Oh, hold on a sec. Don't go anywhere, okay?
Huh? Oh, okay.
You have a good night too, Miss Flattery. Merry Christmas.
She's a very flattering person, Miss Flattery.
Here I am.
To be honest, I
never thought I'd spend Christmas like this. Look at that heavy-duty 240-volt plug. Jesus Christ.
Sorry.
So there is a justification for our actions.
About the life of Nicole Wilson.
It said it was December. It just didn't say what, like, day in December, so.
I get it, too.
Yeah. That's what there was, in the end. There was, like, a strange kind of warmth.
My God, I am doing the exact same thing as people usually do when they're talking to somebody on the phone, just pacing back and forth.
Me and my mom,
or at least that's why I do. I'm on the phone.
House in Billings, and Leonard was here on his own. While I was pretending that I liked my aunt's sweater, he and she were
making a baby.
They
consummating the infidelity of his marriage.
She killed herself, And what she was carrying, too.
Don't be like that.
There you have it. These are my memories, and,
Was it... Wait... Is it the wind chimes?
Was it on your end?
No. What are you talking about?
Like a clinking.
I didn't...
No, I don't hear anything.
I think I'm gonna go check it out.
Okay.
Yeah, it's definitely wind chimes. But first, I'm opening up the... Oh, god damn it, why? Why can't you let me use the secret passage in the wall? That's unfair! Okay, let's follow that noise. Wait. Where are you now? Are you gonna come back, or... megaphone.
Yeah.
I was thinking about earlier, when I said I was happy to have met you.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah.
I was trying to figure out how to tell you. I feel real close to you, Nikki. God.
Nikki?
Talk, I sound like an idiot.
Jesus, you're really getting friendly, aren't you? Can we put this on hold for just a second?
But maybe we should put this conversation on hold.
Yeah.
I want to be there to help you. I'm just a useless voice on the mic.
No, you are incredibly helpful.
Right now,
that's all that matters.
Presence.
Hmm?
You know, people get close in lots of ways.
I'm trying to listen, okay?
I'm trying to listen to this noise.
All right, I get that I might be overdoing it. Sorry, I'm a klutz, and sometimes it's...
Irving, please, shut up. Thanks. Listen, we'll get back to this, but let me figure this out. Where is this sound coming from?
It's coming from this direction.
Anyway, later.
Thank you, Irving. I don't want to be rude. I know that we're having a moment, and you're kind of asking me out on a date, but... Murder eyes. Wait, it felt as though my controller was vibrating as though I was getting close. No, definitely. I was really close there, at least the vibrations felt as though I was close. One second. Oh god! Binaural whispering in my ears. Jesus. Oh, that was my hand coming up, that's all. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Okay, a little bit of piss. Irving?
Hey, sorry I didn't answer. I was busy.
Yeah, well, I...
No problem.
No, it is a bit of a problem. It's not fine. I'm hearing shit.
It's this microphone. Sometimes it captures sounds.
What sounds?
Yeah.
Whispers.
High vibration.
In the crawl spaces. Hotel's full of them.
Yeah, sure.
I don't know about that.
Heads up, and if you sense trouble, just let me know.
That's not a matter of sensing trouble, it's just... Okay, it's definitely coming from this room. Although Oh man, the reflections on the back of this are amazing, holy shit. I don't think they're they are pretty accurate. Yeah, that was an incredibly spooky voice. Not a huge fan of that. Wait, is it coming? No, it's not coming from the floor above. Man! You know, I think if I head up to 217... I still think 217's my answer. That's where that dead rose was. I have to double check on that, but... Oh, fucking Jesus Christ. Man, can you just stop with the random, incredibly loud noises in me ear? You're scaring the dicks out of me. Holy shit. Oh. Too spooky. Yeah, just gonna head this way. It's okay, it's fine. Oh. I just hope nothing just jumps out at my face. That would be the worst. 18. No. Really hard to narrow down. It's not coming from this direction. Definitely. Seems like it's getting louder. I'm hoping that there's going to be like a door open or something at least. No, I'm definitely getting further away. So, it's around this vicinity. 216? Wait, where's 17? There's 17, but 17 has nothing to offer me. Definitely getting some, like... Alright, I'm wandering away or... Starting to lose the thread here. Come on. There we go. That sounds... What the hell? Sounds like an old television program. No, it was... Did you? No, that was just my imagination. Seeing a little light float across there, right? Definitely seems to be coming from here. Can I interact with you in any way, or no? No interactions here. I'm actually kind of not too sure what the game wants from me right about now. I would imagine it wants me to follow the sound, but... Or... how do I know if it's getting closer, or once I've hit the crescendo point? Maybe I'm a floor too high, maybe I need to go back down a level here, or maybe I need to go even further down. The second floor had some real spooky goddamn noises coming out of it, though. Yeah, it was definitely louder upstairs. So I'm gonna go even further downstairs to... What? Or is this place just making all kinds of ridiculous noises? No, it seems pretty loud down here as well. Or maybe I need to follow it back to this dying rose. It's definitely something funky in 217 going on there. I need those room keys. I doubt they're gonna give me that because that's a good way of, eliminating a lot of unnecessary work for yourself is by not having to model every room. It's like, sorry, door is locked. What can you do? Alright, picking up strange noises. Everywhere, picking up strange noises. I'm just gonna end up wandering through this whole goddamn place, aren't I? Well, I'm really off the thread. No. The ballroom? It's not the first time I've come here, but... Wait, was that like that before? Yeah, this was pretty similar. I think I've gone through this way. Really, it's just going to be me wandering around, listening to noise, and being like, is this, Oh, fuck off. Fuck off with that. Okay. Ooh, okay.
Found anything?
I think I did.
Can't hear that sound anymore.
It's easy to freak out when you're on your own up there.
I have to get this place fumigated. There's rats or something. Yeah, there's the bang on the door there. What?
You know, for a second, it was nice to imagine that the past could come back like that.
No, it kind of not is. It's not really that nice.
December 23rd. Maybe you heard about it? It's pretty well known in the county.
Sounds amazing.
You should have seen the ballroom back then.
I can almost picture it.
We even had a little bit of a ballroom dance.
His family was there. Reverend Foster... wasn't as sullen as usual.
And your parents?
My mother had eyes only for Leonard.
Unfortunately, Leonard had hands for other women. So he wouldn't stop like Rachel. That girl.
Rachel.
She talked and moved with the grace and confidence of an adult.
I'm locked in here, I can't move.
She wore a dress with a bow on her back. She was so beautiful.
It's a blue dress.
Perfect. It was the beginning of the end, and we were breaking out the champagne.
Your father might agree with you that she was a perfect fuck. You never know.
Sorry, I'm becoming a freaking nostalgic up here.
Well, I'm hearing creaking to my right, and that's not great. I don't appreciate that.
I'm gonna look around again, and then I'm going to bed.
Be careful.
Wow, Christ, really, that's it? Just come down here, take a look at this stuff, observe the picture, and call it a day? Man, when you're not reading every book in the game, this experience flies by pretty damn quickly. I feel as though... Oh, Jesus Christ, wow, fuck me. Oh, stop doing that. Please stop doing that. Holy shit. Wow. Day 8. I like how it's just a soft little drum tap. A boom, boom. It's not like the Law and Order noise. Boom, boom. But something akin to that. Another weird dream? Or... hopefully it's just a weird dream? Yeah, not a fan of... sacred image. Organ, waking up in some weird-ass church. Jesus! Okay. This is kind of a lectern. Nice. Thinking about Father. Father Foster. Or Preacher Foster? Bottle? Can't really interact with the bottle. Jesus, it's a little bit dark in here. My goodness. Jesus! I guess I'm just going to go into the you know, not horrifyingly spooky, creepy basement of the church. Is there actually a chapel attached to the hotel, or am I, like, upstairs in an attic area? Why would there be children playing hopscotch in here? In such a basic, lame pattern, too. Come on, now. Get a triple in there. I'm talking mad shit. I'm going to be pissing my pants in half a second from now. I can feel it welling up. My back teeth are floating in it. Goddamn rats. I hear rats. Come on now, guys. You're going to have a little bit of safety around here. Put a handrail on that. Not just a... I'm going to walk into a dark-ass corner all by my... Well, I am by myself. I'm not... No one else is going to be here. Hopefully no one else is going to be here. No, is this the door that was blocked off with the pallet in the basement? Or over by the kitchen? Really? There's a super creepy church attached to the... Oh. My. God. Well, I'm not pleased about waking up in there. Not in the goddamn least I'm not. No, no, no. But I'm happy that... Oh, I'm back to somewhere that I recognize. Hey there, farting old ghost. How you doing? Good. Happy to hear that you're still just banging away. Picture. That's that postcard. How? Why? Why did I wake up there? Why is it so dilapidated and just shitty? You know what? Fuck it. I'm going back to my car. I'm tired of this shit. I don't want to be here no more. I don't care if it's 6 feet of snow outside. I know it's less than 4 feet, but still, you know, fuck this. This bullshit. And these double swinging doors. Like, who puts that many double hinges on so many doors? Okay, just looking at the level again. Why? Weird blackout. It seemed as though I blacked out the moment I walked out or into the ballroom. From looking at that picture. Man. Wait, map? I don't have any of my inventory stuff. Is this actually a dream? The fact that I woke up in a strange place and... Although I'm back to somewhere familiar that I recognize. That was odd. But I don't have any of my shit. I still don't know where the fuck that climbing pickaxe went. That? Not a fan of that. You know, I'm not going to check out the game room. I'm going to head back to the ballroom. Just out of curiosity. Maybe I'll see myself laying on the floor. In a bit of a heap, a hump, or a slump. Ooh. Random knocking, random banging noises. Just trying not to think about it. Yeah. So that's where I fell asleep here, maybe? Potentially? Possibly? I thought something weird or strange would occur from that, but... yeah, no, just back to the old picture. Alright, let's have a bit of a do-over here. Looked at the picture, I'm just gonna head myself to bed, alright? Walking out here, dum-da-dum. Yep, dum-da-dum-dum-dum. Nothing to see, nothing to do, nothing strange going on here at all. Yeah, fuck that, I'm going back to my room. Mm-mm, nope, no thank you. Because I can't pull up my map, so I can't take a look at any of my mission objectives. I don't have my flashlight, so if the lights go out, I'm going to have a very bad time. And, why did I wake up in the church? That's super, super weird. Didn't even know that there was a chapel. No, that would bring me upstairs. It would be down this way. Man, this is spooky, like too spooky. Everything fine in here? I'm just gonna close that up. Okay, cool. Thank you. the master suite, where everything's safe and everything's fine and everything's comfortable. Where'd the Christmas music go? Come on, now! I miss my Christmas music. I just want to turn that shit back on. That's all I need. That's all I want. Was there something I was supposed to look at in the church there? I just didn't see it, or I missed it, or something like that. Inventory. Why is my inventory here? How come? Why?
Merry Christmas, Nikki.
Not right now, okay?
It's a late for holiday greetings, but I expected that.
Irving, I'm having a bit of a problem right now, okay?
Hey, is everything okay?
Yes. I mean...
No, no.
I don't think so.
It's fucking not.
What happened?
I sleepwalked.
Like in the old Laurel and Hardy movies?
I don't know what that is a reference to.
I woke up in church, standing in front of the lectern.
Wow. Does that happen a lot?
No, I'm an atheist.
One doesn't just become a sleepwalker from one day to the next.
Yeah, I used to sleepwalk when I was a child.
One time in February, I ended up outside.
Ooh, that's not a good thing.
The door's unlocked if their kid sleepwalks.
I never told anyone.
Well, you can't just latch and lock your child into a bedroom. That's kind of screwed up.
That's not the point.
Well, that explains why I did sleepwalking while I was a kid then.
Then I come back here and it happens again. If I ended up in that church, maybe there's a reason.
Sometimes following your instinct is the best thing.
Well, now that I have a flashlight, I guess I can go back to the church and investigate.
But I'll think about it.
But it is fucking spooky.
Oh, Irving?
Yeah?
Sorry about earlier. Hey, yeah. I like Nikki.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Nikki.
Aw. He didn't get completely scared off from me cutting him off earlier. Okay, so I have you back. And I have my flashlight. The depth of field on that flashlight's a little bit aggressive, honestly. I wish they'd turn that down. Or at least give you the option to just disable depth of field. I don't really care for it, honestly. It's one of those features where it's like, ooh, look at how cinematic and cool we are. Just an old hotel, that's all. It's just a little bit creepy and kooky and creaky and... what is that noise? No, it's just a din of the building, that's all. Nothing to worry about. Nothing too special with that. It's fine. Oh, I have my map back. Oh. That was weird. So I checked out the restrooms. I've been in the fireplace room. I've gone through the kitchen, and that's the freezer. I don't think I can ever go back to the freezer. Been all through there. Checked out the museum. Master suite. been to the Overlook. I haven't been up in the attic, though, and that's that section that I think is chained off, or it's inaccessible on the second floor because it's through that wing that's under construction. Yeah, from the museum, you have that first hallway and can go through the second hallway, maybe? Or am I... Yeah. And then from there, it gets blocked off by the time you get past the... maybe a little bit further around. Or no, it's that other wing. It's where the orange overlaps on the far right there. I have to go back to a church. Don't want, really, but my sleepwalking must be a sign. Okay, thank goodness. Thank you, map, for actually giving me a directive of, well, where I want to go, where I should be going to get a little bit of progression going on here instead of me just wandering about. Yep. Exception. Oh, I thought I could ring the bell, but no, it's just a standard observe prompt. Okay. Back to the super spooky church. I guess I welled up the strength and energy to move that pallet out of the way and open the door. Hey, Irving.
I was thinking, there really could be a repressed reason as to why you ended up there.
Let's rule out a divine calling, shall we?
The idea that I received our Lord's calling in the dream?
I never thought about that. Sister Nicole doesn't sound bad at all, though.
Fuck off.
What?
Hey, language, Sister Nicole.
All right.
Oh.
So, if I think about the church, I think about my mother. She often helped Reverend Foster. She decorated for holidays, did fundraising, and put up booths to involve the whole community in parish activities. You know, that kind of stuff.
I know what you mean.
I think she found gratification in doing that. Something she didn't get elsewhere. Including the hotel. When we moved to Portland, she quit.
Fundraising?
God.
I gather you didn't exactly have a high opinion of your mother when you were a kid.
Well, you know, she found the Lord.
I was always running after Leonard. He was much more fun than she was, no doubt about it.
He had a big old brain on him.
Capable of calculating the motion of celestial bodies while taking apart and refitting a motorcycle in less than half an hour.
What about her?
In the same half hour, she could have audited a business balance sheet. There you go.
Well, she was a master chef as well, from the certificates on the wall.
No. What I understood later, living in such proximity to her, is that Mom loved feeling needed.
Well, doesn't everybody?
A community like ours makes you feel needed, without a doubt.
So that's where I want to go. I want to take a look at that lonely boot before I head off to the church. It's always a hell of a thing, growing up, getting a little bit more mature, and kind of gaining the perspective and, well, just understanding or trying to understand your parents a little bit better. So there's a ski route attached to this place as well then, hey? That would make sense, being at the base of a mountain, that skiing would be a bit of a draw, something that really brings in people. But as I was mentioning about, like, relating with your parents, or coming to conclusions, or recognizing patterns that you see, and it's just like, oh, that's kind of like what my parents did, or the moment that I found out that I was so damn similar to my father, that I made the same horrible jokes, and, well, inherited my sense of humor from the man. It actually... Really, I picked it up from my brothers, who inherited it from him. Okay. This is... Man. They really carved their way through the mountain. Got the lectern here. Can report in on that, but before we do... Sleeping bag. Oh, fuck. Okay. Alright, let's start with one thing at a time, then. Man, that motion of her hand coming up scares the hell out of me.
She got out the usual streamers and decorations and stuff. She raced in and out of the church, but I never discovered where she kept all those things.
Never asked?
Oh, a million times. She didn't want to answer. She said they were in a safe place. A real mystery.
What kind of decorations could they have possibly been?
Nothing explosive. It's just that I had the bad habit of sneaking all over the place and forgetting what time it was. There was that huge lady, the assistant cook, Mrs. Bryce.
Oh, shit. Mother wasn't the cook then. That means I've been attributing the wrong things.
The secret storeroom when I got older, but I must have forgotten.
The mystery of the secret storeroom. Ooh, sounds good.
The riddle.
What?
Are you talking about?
There's a riddle now?
Good at keeping secrets. But he taught me a riddle to get there.
Oh. It's been a long, long time.
Yes. Oh, something like, down the stairs, watch your step, don't fall apart, or it's your end. Round a corner, turn around, there's your way in front of you. All that's closed can be open too if you see beyond its looks. But how can I remember it? How?
It's just burned into your brain. It's one of those weird things.
Total mystery. Want to play?
Yes. I need to think about it. I have no idea what it means.
Yeah, I don't understand at all what the hell this is all about. But I'm sure we're going to be able to find Sacred Image. Hey, Leonard, what do you know about the fear of God?
The paintings of the saints. I was convinced Leonard had gotten rid of them.
Why?
He liked saying that it was more likely to find God in a supernova than in a church.
I don't see what he had in common with the Reverend Solomon Foster.